Welcome back from the break. We're still here with our guest, Estella Kabagaya. What plans do you have? Because you really like the vulnerable women, but you notice that all women are vulnerable in that space, in that particular space, be it the corporate woman or the one in the market. Mm-hmm. At one point, all we want is good childcare, especially from 0 to 3 years.
What's the plan for all of you? The plan doesn't have the corporate people. Where I can only, well, the only little bit I can do for the corporate people is to come, help you set up the space, get your childminder, and pass by and make sure she follows instructions. Yes, but I have a heart for the vulnerable, so the deeply vulnerable business women, because when you look at our people now, you the corporate, you're paid. Medical insurance, you have all those nice things that come even with your salary. Some of you even have, like the parliamentarians, they have car allowance, all these allowances. This vulnerable woman, actually, she pays the biggest tax because every tax hit the last consumer. So she pays all those taxes and no one is supporting her. And then she has to work hard to thrive, improve her income, and also offer medication and take her children to school. So I believe if I support her at an affordable fee and take away the child in a safe space, she will thrive. Her productivity will increase. Increased productivity, increased income. Definitely she will be able to support her family. Gone are the days where all these women were supposed to start home.
True.
These days, even when they're marrying, it's like, are you working? So we are all allowed to hustle. So the women who are supposed to sit back home and take care of the children, they no longer have that laxity. They have to work. So everyone needs childcare support. And when it comes to the child, where you find a mother, you find a child.
True.
So they will always be in the workspaces. But unfortunately, why I'm more into the market women is that the city council policy is very clear. Children are not allowed in markets. And markets are the biggest women employers.
True.
Informal. So I'll prefer to work with these women for now. Give it an opportunity. But also now, how will I survive way beyond the funding I get?
True.
I have to plan my sustainability. As a social entrepreneur, I look at what can I do with the same women, grow them, so that they are able to pay me, to afford my services, yes. So we do even skilling in their own space. What else do you love to do? How else do you love to support you? So I empower them in other personal development skills so that they thrive both financially and in personal growth. When they thrive, it will be easy for their children to thrive.
Now, when you started this back in 2017, you say, did you have any other model you wanted to emulate, or was it an avant-garde thing, you going out to try what you've always wanted to do, to work with children? Because it sounds like a first to me. I wonder which model you copied to do this.
It became, I usually have crazy ideas, by the way. So it came within me. One, I wanted a space that does not teach class. Because I don't want the stress that goes with teaching. Homework, I tell they didn't mark, the teachers didn't come. If it's playing, whether that material mind has come or not, me, I'll just enter and roll. We roll over, we enjoy. So I don't need people who are going to give me a headache. So me, in my mind, my model never had the formal education. So I never thought of a school. And in my life, I'm not going to build a school.
Okay.
I want everything about children, excluding class.
Okay.
Yes. So I came out with my weird, out of the blue. But then out of the blue, you know, when you have this weird idea, there's nothing that has never been done under,
Google.
Yes, Mr. Google. Whereas it was sending me to different countries, including Kenya, that for them they've ever done it. So I was like, okay, but you know, Google will show they've ever done it, they do this way, but there's something that they do that you don't wish in your model. So I was like, okay, They do that. Also, there is information people will never put on Google. Private information, my model, I have to keep it to myself. If you want it, you come to me. So that information you would not get on Google. So I just picked tits and bits. Okay, they've said this, it's possible, it's doable. Then I'll implement it.
I hope though that you can share with us like the tenants, the main things such a center should have. You keep all the other special things to yourself, but the main tenants, when you're dealing with children in a center, what should the center have that it shouldn't miss for it to be worthwhile?
Worthwhile. We are looking at the first 1,000 days. Those are the 3 years.
True.
Basics. Basic number one is you must think about their nutrition. So the reason why we offer hot meals, I don't want you to bring porridge in your flask. Then your porridge gets spoiled. It gets spoiled. So I don't feed your child. So for me, nutrition is very important. Whereas some centers will say, bring your own meals.
A snack.
Yeah. Pack your own snack. Yeah. Then we shall give it to the child when it's ready. That doesn't work in my head. And also in my head, I want kids to get used that we all eat the same. I feed you on Mukene. All of you are having those tiny fish in your plate. So you're not going to say, the other one has meat. Because now with the one day, women were working in the food section. One could be able to bring Irish, another one brings rice, another one can bring chicken. So I tell them, you're going to confuse my children.
True.
And I'm going to cause World War V. So nutrition is very important because this is the basis of the children. They are
you have a cook.
I cook my meals, which are monitored. Because I know my porridge right now, it's very ready and the sugar is enough. And at least like a sugar, even if it's small, and the milk, they have a hot meal.
Okay.
Then it comes to cognitive skills. They're trying to use their hands. They're learning how to crawl. Because some of the kids come at a very tender age. They're learning how to crawl. So
seat.
So we do the benzins. The old school, how you do it at home. You do the benzins, pack clothes, help them to steal. Try to speak, to communicate to them using your face. Because kids read faces.
Yeah,
so, and that is a communication skill. So all those skills a mother would have done at home, we endeavor to do that. Then we introduce identifying colors, at least the four basic colors, the blue, the red. So then you're like, okay, I think someone loves orange. Because every time we pass orange, that's their favorite colors. We are just introducing them. But that's not in the first 2 years. That is now from 2 to 3. We are introducing them that, making sounds, doing some singing, saying I'm sorry, hugging, hello. So those are all, thank you, those are all what a mother would have done at home. And that is what we do. The only difference is now we are doing it in a group. They learn how to share. They learn how to socialize.
Okay.
Yes.
Now, importantly, since the market, like you said, the market is a collection point of people from all corners of this country, perhaps even East Africa, you may find someone from Kenya in the market. What language do you use?
What language do we use? Yes, because they come when the mothers speak different languages. We endeavor to teach them the basic English. Basic English, because even the employees themselves come from across. Yes, come from across. And also, so that when we communicate to one child, the other one understands. And also, when it comes to this age group, we use a lot of actions. When you're calling the child, you add...
Come.
Gosh, I don't remember last time I did that.
Yeah, you have to do it then. Okay. Because now at this stage, we even don't know if the child can hear. At this stage, also we have a challenge of disabilities that are not physical. So we are trying to understand, can she make noise? This one doesn't make noise. This one doesn't cry. This one is aggressive. This is what... But also that helps us to give the parents feedback that your child, I think there is something that is not right, that is not very normal, which is the hardest paper to tell a parent.
Of course, it's painful.
Very painful.
Okay. In doing all this, noble as it may be, we all know life is not without its challenges. What challenges have you faced?
Challenges. With one day, it was so political, that one. Then the challenges you have, whereas all these women love the service, there is either one person who's anti whatever you're doing, you do it wrong. Because I see this even in schools, everywhere, even in a community. Whatever thing you're doing, someone's like, but why? Now we have a challenge of LGBT.
Okay.
Why are you taking our children at a tender age? These people, what cartoons do they watch? Because I watch the cartoons prior,
okay,
and I have the same cartoons. And I make sure I tell people, you should watch the cartoons.
The parents?
Yes, the parents, we can, oh, if you're free, you can always come in and watch. Why? Because we have to guard the name as well. And also show them that even if it's affordable, you can be hiding in making it affordable, yet somewhere, somehow, you're implanting something, yes. And it makes people very sensitive.
True.
And I tell the parents, yes, you have a right to be inquisitive.
Mm.
If you feel you're uncomfortable, anything, tell us. If it's the videos we watch, you can come and see. If it is, but also some of these vices that kids have come from home.